join us, come and wait an hour or two. Ah, oh, you lead the journey, turning to a spot exciting, mystic and exotic journey through our anecdotic view. We've got magic to do just for you. Hearts to perform, hearts to warm, kings and things to take by storm as we go along our way.
There's power when people come together with a shared vision. You might even say, there's a common thread and the power of we. Service learning makes the most of this power by inspiring kids to collaborate in addressing different local and global issues and needs. Building a shared vision brings together people with many different gifts, interests, perspectives, and backgrounds. Using these assets, teachers help their students bond together to accomplish their goals.
We brought both hybrid and online students together because we wanted them all to have this experience and opportunity and work on collaboration, communication, and leadership skills. We also wanted to empower students during a pretty powerless time.
We just noticed how kids weren't being included. We just realized how people just needed an ally or a friend to hang out with.
In Changemakers, we created masks, and on the masks we put messages so that everyone can be included.
The action that we did is handing out a whole bunch of masks, and so we could also take donations so we can do more of this and get more masks, and so we could also stop the spread of COVID-19.
That it's always good to support your community and try to make them stronger.
Before, I didn't really know how to exactly make people feel like they belong, but now I know and I feel much better about it.
And students grew impassioned about encouraging people in the community, in their schools, and in the broader Upper Arlington community to stand up for each other, to help everyone feel that they belong, and to be more inclusive. And they had a lot of fun writing scripts. They were script writers, actors, editors for videos that raised awareness, like public service announcements, and they did a lot of the designing. They did all the artwork and planning and marketing for the masks.
For someone who has who is kind of quiet, it kind of made me feel like I had a voice to help, to help the community.
When I today, when I was walking down the halls, I saw lots of people wearing the masks, and it just felt good to think people were supporting us. So thank you for making that possible. And I also saw kids reading the flyers, and it was sort of fun to see their reactions.
Hi, we are seniors from Pickerington North, and we are enrolled in Service Learning Academic Tutoring. I'm Caroline.
And I'm Anna. And we took this class because we wanted to make an impact on the youth in our community.
We really want us to be change makers, and we have really enjoyed getting to know all of these kids over this past year, both virtually and in person.
We did the heartbreak map, and our classes were led to three topic areas. These topic areas were mental health, climate change, and racial justice.
Our project following our mental health unit was to create a public service announcement for our community.
We chose the song You Will Be Found from Dear Evan Hansen because Dear Evan Hansen is a musical all about mental health and the importance of knowing that you are loved and you are known by your community.
We hope you enjoy our PSA.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear?
Like you could fall and no one would hear? Well, let that lonely feeling wash away.
Maybe there's a reason to believe you'll be okay.
'Cause when you don't feel strong enough to stand, you can reach out.
Someone will come running, and I know we'll take you home.
Even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you.
My favorite parts of this class were being able to work with young students and learning about racial injustice and new cultures.
So my favorite things about this class is that I get to learn about real world issues and problems, and I like to work with the younger students. To be in service learning is to be a small spark of change. Together we can create the fire that will leave a big impact. Service learning not only taught me how to make a change, but also how to want to make a change.
I joined this program with the notion that I would only be helping kids, but instead I am graduating with life lessons regarding the current world we live in. You showed us how a small lesson can be transformed into a movement.
There were these kids in Africa. They went to a school that didn't have enough books to educate the kids properly.
We were donating books to schools and libraries in Sierra Leone.
We started a book drive. You can bring in any books you wanted. Then when the book drive ended, we shipped all the books over to the schools in Africa.
Because in Sierra Leone, in the schools and libraries, they don't have as many books as we do here.
I felt really good after it because helping someone always feels good.
It made me feel happy because I was helping people and that didn't have as much stuff as me.
The students in our class felt so proud, and they were so empathetic of the people in Sierra Leone who are in these schools and don't have books or materials. One of the cool things that they did that I think tied them to this project, or tied them emotionally to this project so much, was we did a Zoom with a young woman named Yabom, who actually went to high school in Sierra Leone and now lives in the U.S. And this is her way of giving back. And she just taught them so much and talked so much about her experience, and it made them feel connected to her, and it made them feel empowered to do something.
Hi, my name is Janie Nocera, and I have a few of my fourth graders from Wycliffe Progressive Elementary School here to talk to you about a poetry project we did with our second, third grade buddies in Katie Kaplan's class. We were inspired by Amanda Gorman's poem, The Hill We Climb. In our class, this developed into a poetry unit celebrating diverse voices and poetry styles. And with our buddies, this evolved into illustrating Amanda Gorman's poem on canvas pieces with the help of our incredible art teacher, Lindsay Bennett. Here are some fourth graders to tell you about it.
Hi, our names are
Derek,
Kate,
Tilly,
Emma,
Abby,
and Andre.
We'll be sharing about a project we made after listening to Amanda Gorman's poem, The Hill We Climb.
We did this with our buddies in Ms. Kaplan's class. The poem really spoke out to us because some of the bonds were very inspiring, so we illustrated them on a poster.
Then on a quilt square. We first heard the poem after listening to the inauguration.
Then in Ms. Kaplan's class, we watched it again.
The process. First we listened to the poem. Then we cut out pieces of the poem and illustrated.
Then we put parts of the poem on quilt squares.
We are still in the process, but when we are done, it's going to be a big quilt in our building.
This poem was not written by us. It was written by the amazing Amanda Gorman.
Helped and worked on by Mrs. Nocera's class,
Ms. Kaplan's class, and our teacher was very helpful in this project.
And some grandparents helped weave it together. It was inspired by Amanda Gorman's poem.
The quilt is still in progress, and it's turning out great!
This is Amalia.
And this is Taran.
And we are in the online academy from Hastings Middle School. We originally created this presentation to share with our sixth grade advisory, but we encourage other students, parents, and teachers to share this presentation as it includes important information and resources.
The issues we addressed in our presentation were racism, racial inequality pertaining to women and women of color in today's society, and gender inequality and feminism. The needs we considered were definitions of terms such as bias, implicit bias, AAPI, BIPOC, and POC. Some other needs we considered were female role models that deserve recognition, books, information, and media that we have reviewed and think hold proper representation and education for students to enjoy. The last needs we considered were resources about racism and sexism, brainstorming ideas to engage students' minds to think about these serious topics on a deeper level, and optional places to donate.
Especially coming from a place of being people of color ourselves, we think it's important for every student to have access to resources, have proper and reliable information, and to become passionate about learning about issues regarding civil rights for everyone. We explain that an educated student is the greatest weapon against things that are unjust in the world.
We learned more about specific statistics concerning the Black community, the AAPI community, and the gender pay gap and unequal opportunities for women. We hope to learn that more people are standing up for what they believe in and making a difference no matter how big or small.
We felt excited and satisfied that we were able to make it this far in making a difference. We felt inspired to do more and reach as far as we can. We felt accomplished that we could create a presentation that can be presented to any group of any size, whether that be in person or over Zoom, 4 people or 40 people.
We were able to spread awareness and education to other students. We have also sent the presentation and resources to students and families in the online academy. The presentation was also shared with students at Hastings Middle School through advisory. We hope that we can inspire and empower other students to make a difference. Other students could create projects, art, or share information to their families about recent issues. We hope to spread this information to a broader group of people.
Hello, everyone. I really appreciate the opportunity to join you today and share my gratitude. As many of you know, we have a long tradition of valuing service learning in Upper Arlington. Our teachers know that service learning projects help our students understand concepts on a deeper, more personal level. Learning by doing and helping gives them an amazing life experience, and that helps them retain what they have learned and inspires them to continue making our community a better place. Many of you also know that service learning isn't always the easiest way to teach a lesson. It involves a lot of hard work, planning, and collaboration. These things are never easy, but this year, in the midst of a pandemic, they were even more difficult. So I want to thank all the teachers who, despite all of the challenges of this crazy year, remained committed to service learning. These projects have brought excitement and joy to our students when they needed it most.